Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm Hrithyanshu. Today we are gonna unravel the secrets of one of my favorite topics, this vast and mysterious universe. Now let's start with the topic. What is the universe? As we can see, the universe comprises of all galaxies, celestial bodies, stars, planets, gases, dust clouds, light, etc. It is considered as an endless space. We all belong to this universe. Now let's take an overview of all these spatial terminologies. The first one is galaxies. A galaxy is a huge collection of gas, dust, billions of stars and their solar systems held together by gravity. We live on the planet Earth in the Milky Way galaxy. Galaxies are of different shapes. The most important three forms are elliptical, irregular, and spiral. Elliptical shape means a flattened oval-shaped galaxy. This is the most common form. Irregular-shaped galaxies are very small and do not possess any distinct shape. Spiral. This type has spiral arms, look like a spinning wheel. Our Milky Way galaxy is a spiral type. The Milky Way galaxy contains our solar system. It appears as a band because of its disc-shaped structure. Galileo Galilei first resolved the band of light into individual stars with his telescope in 1610. Here comes the constellation. A constellation is a group of stars that appears to form a pattern or picture like Orion the Great Hunter, Leo the Lion, Taurus the Bull, Ursa Major or Big Dipper in a form of a bear. There are 88 official constellations out there. These are easily recognizable patterns that help people orient themselves using the night sky. Let's move on to the star. A star is a luminous ball of gas, mostly hydrogen and helium, held together by its own gravity. These are huge balls of fire. They appear as tiny dots of light. Proxima Centauri is the closest star to the sun. It is in red dwarf state right now. Let's explore the sun now. It is the closest star to our Earth. The sun is a yellow dwarf star. Dwarf star means a star having low or average luminosity, mass, and size. It is a hot ball of glowing gases at the heart of our solar system. It is nearly a perfect sphere of hot plasma. Plasma is considered as the fourth state of matter. Just as liquid boils and forms vapor or gas, when gas is heated, it forms plasma. Its gravity holds everything from the biggest planets like Jupiter to tiny debris in its orbit. How did this great, glorious sun come into existence? Let's dive in. The sun and the planets formed together around 4.5 billion years ago from a cloud of gas and dust called the solar nebula. It all started at the Orion spur of the Milky Way galaxy. What happened is, a cloud of dust and another cloud of gas collided with each other and formed the solar nebula. After the formation of the solar nebula, probably a shockwave from a nearby supernova explosion initiated the collapse of the nebula. Then due to high gravity and pressure, it started spinning faster and turned into a shape of disk. Everything started to clump at the center, which made a protostar. After millions of years, due to the increase of temperature and pressure, the hydrogen fusion suddenly jump-started and the sun came into life and the planets formed in a thin disk orbiting around it.
I'm winding up here with the discussion about the Sun. Stay tuned for my further informative videos of this series. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you liked the video. Thank you.